Hey everyone, welcome back to some Starfleet Academy, I hope. I'm gonna share my entire screen first while we load this up, just because last time I think this was one of those games I wasn't able to tab out of once I started it, so give me 1 second, we'll get everything started up here. Of course we'll be using the most mighty ship in the entire Federation, the Oberth class. Yeah, okay, so I can't tap back out of this for some reason. One second, I'll pull up the chat. Not gonna be a very long stream, just figured I was about to call it a night, but why not play for a little while? I know we were gonna play the I know I said we were gonna play Armada again, but a game kind of annoyed me the other night, so I think let's try this one again, since we never really actually finished the first mission ever, so. I think I figured it out, so I think we should be able to at least get done with the first one. I know it's kind of boring, just kind of, from what I remember, the first mission is we have to save a ship and shoot lots of mines, apparently. I was playing offline not that long ago, and I almost finished the mission, but then I ran the ship into the space station, so it exploded, and I failed. So hopefully this time we'll actually get through this first mission. Hey John, how's it going? We're heading back to Starfleet Academy for a little bit tonight. Everyone thinks the Constitution class is so great. We'll show everyone that the Oberth class is the mightiest ship in the fleet. And that's why, unlike the Constitution class, the Oberth is still widely in use in the 24th century. Look at all those happy people.
Welcome, cadets. I am Commandant X Rothro, and I am very proud to welcome you to Starfleet Academy Command School.
Thank you.
Ever since Starfleet Academy was founded, the United Federation of Planets has sought the best and the brightest from over a thousand worlds.
Shut up, John. The Oberth class is the secret warship of the Federation. Everyone thinks it's just cannon fodder, but it's actually the strongest ship in the entire fleet. In the entire quadrant, I would say.
We'll make it, Captain.
2 years ago,
God damn it,
Sulu, we put out the call once again.
And push him off the ship.
To boldly go where no man has gone before.
Leave Sulu in the ocean.
Docking procedure is getting longer and longer every time.
Now, I'm sure you've all heard a lot about the Starfleet Academy simulator.
Hey, Thomas. Stop clapping for
those
the simulator, losers.
Will become the starship captains and command crews of tomorrow. But first, you must learn the grave responsibilities of command. It is now my distinct honor to introduce the new chief of command school.
Oh my God. No wonder Starfleet's all screwed up.
I'm Captain Hikaru Sulu. I'll be with you the next 2 years before I take command of the USS Excelsior. It's my job
to create
the Starfleet captains of the future. I will test you on your ability to manage your crew. Remember,
exactly. Yeah,
you will no longer be judged solely by your own conduct, but also by the conduct of those you command. And now, my close friend and our distinguished guest, Captain James T. Kirk.
Thank you.
Yay!
Thank you. Welcome to Command College. You've just embarked.
So great at command school.
The most challenging.
Next assignment
course
was to spend 3 years checking Dash's anomaly. Exactly.
And also,
they just needed him out of the way.
It is often said that command school cadets are the best of the best, and it's also said that I commanded the best ship, and the best crew. Truth is, there's no such thing as the best. One
Bullshit.
Ship may be brand new, state of the art,
and the Oberth class is the
countless
best.
Bugs to work out. Another ship may be 100 years old and shake like a rattle, but the bugs are long gone, and that's why she's 100 years old. Same goes for your crew. They may be technical wizards, but if they can't work as a team, their skills are useless to you.
Much
when
like
you
Sulu.
Meet your crew, you'll find 1,000 abilities and talents and flaws all crackling against each other. And that's where you come in. Those of you who succeed in building a team will be among the elite few to take us to the stars. Good luck, fair weather, and never forget that risk is your business.
Oh my God. Bring back the simulator. All right, let's do this. New game. Look at that, a pink
Cadet's
chair
log.
Just for me.
First entry. Cadet David Forrester logging on. Today they took us for a tour of the simulator. And for the first time, I met my crew. That's Jeffrey Corrin, my navigator. He's from one of the wealthiest families on
Earth. I never played this one back when it was on.
Rumor has it he was up for command school, but didn't take it because he doesn't
like
responsibility.
The only one I ever bought was...
Of course, rumor also has it that his photon torpedoes
judgment
never
rights. And that one was on 10.3.5.
At the helm is Janna Acton. She's from the mining colony on Rigel 12 in the Levantine Expanse. She hasn't had an easy life. They live pretty rough out there, especially by
true.
Federation standards.
DS9, that was on 1CD.
My engineer is Robin Brady.
And
from
Legacy,
Colorado,
too.
On Earth.
That was a good one.
He's
but
a quiet
liked
guy.
It for some reason.
But I'm told he can tear apart and rebuild a warp drive in record time. Over by communications, that's Vanda Magia.
What a freak.
She's the oldest daughter of a prominent Andorian ambassador. Most Andorians never expected her to take on a heavy responsibility like Starfleet. My science officer is Sturrock from Vulcan.
Of course.
I worked with him in some
computer
classes.
Stereotypical Vulcan.
Year. He's brilliant, even by Vulcan standards.
Cadets,
get off my ship.
We're scheduled to complete familiarization later this morning. And this afternoon, we fly our first real simulator mission, our trial by fire. Let's hope we're ready for it.
Save. Mission one done. That was an incredible mission. Alright, what the fuck? Continue.
Cadets, this is your first Starfleet Academy mission. Several star systems are threatened by drifting minefields. Your job is to destroy the mines and to capture the devices controlling them.
We got
further
this.
Instructions will be sent to you as your mission progresses. Now, Mr. Forrester, we need you to choose your vessel. The more powerful your vessel, the more difficult the scenario will become.
Your berth.
I'd like the Oberth-class vessel.
An Oberth-class ship? That will be a challenge.
Captain's log.
Exactly.
Stardate 2967.5.
As I said, the more powerful a ship,
weapons of war do not recognize truces, ceasefires, or peace treaties. They're capable of killing millennia after their wars have been forgotten. Our mission involves these weapons. We must neutralize several dangerous minefields that are threatening Federation space.
Message from Starbase, Captain.
Warp to system S1222. By pressing keys Shift and W to engage warp. Your course is automatically plotted by your navigator if it is a mission objective.
Course laid in, Captain.
Engage, fools.
Entering system 1222, Captain.
After entering the system, go to red alert by pressing the A key and then the R key. Target a mine. Use the keypad zero or period keys to cycle through targets. The targeted item will have a square around it. If the square is red, it is in phaser range. If the red square has crosshairs, the target is in photon torpedo range. The keypad plus keys selects the nearest target. These mines fire weapons at the ship and explode in close proximity to the ship. Do not approach them too closely. Button 1 on the joystick will fire phasers, and button 2 will fire the photon torpedoes.
I don't have a joystick.
Each ship has a limited complement of photon torpedoes on board, so use them sparingly.
All right. Plus, and we want the closest one. Don't know how to steer. Shields. Shit. This could be a problem. What the hell is going on? How do I steer this freaking ship? Oh no, how do I get out of this screen? This is... There we go. Aha! I don't know what this is. Hey, Wes. How do I... turns phasers to auto. J-Y-O. Buttons. Oh, okay. I figured out how to increase our speed. Problem is, I still haven't figured out how to turn us. This could be an issue. S doesn't do anything. I need to look at the settings. Keyboard. Ship's controls. Let's see. Turn left, pad 4. I'm not using it. Oh, no. Alright, let's see if I have the controller plugged in, so maybe that's... Oh, hey, I can use the controller. Sweet. All right, so we need to target something.
Port side shields have been hit. Port side shields down to 50%. Port side shields are critical, sir.
Hit the fucking mine.
destroyed yet.
I guess we're just going to use torpedoes because... Not in range. We'll speed up.
Mine destroyed.
Mine destroyed is right.
Portside shields repaired.
Good job. Peons. This thing like does not aim where the crosshairs are. It's kind of stupid.
Mine destroyed. Mine destroyed.
Nothing can stop our incredible crew. I don't understand. You'd think that the green thing would be your aiming. For some reason. You can't shoot anywhere near where you're shooting. With the green thing. It's weird. Awesome. Now what? We're not done yet? Oh, there's another mine. Some dirty Klingon mine.
Mine destroyed, Captain.
Excellent work is right, Sulu. We passed it.
Portside shields have been hit.
Mine destroyed.
Good job.
Portside shields repaired.
Excellent work. Hey, LD. Why does it sound like Star Wars? It doesn't! How dare you, Wes? Dominate this mission. Starfleet's gonna have to take command of a real ship. They're so incredible. I feel like there's another mine right over here somewhere. Ah.
Mine destroyed, Captain.
We're lined up. Let's go faster.
Mine destroyed.
shoot it?
That shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working.
Fucking idiots. Shoot it, don't run into it, morons.
Lower shields online.
It's weird that they're not showing up on the screen. Or the tactical radar view thing. Looking for another. There we go. There you are, you son of a bitch. How are we not hitting you? Screw you.
Our shields have been hit!
Oh, it has shields. It's a ship. It's not even a... It's not a...
Lower shields repaired. Upper shields repaired.
Why is it so fucking hard to aim? For random speed, I guess.
Captain, we've cracked our dilithium crystals. We won't be going
during the course of your mission, your ship was lost. That is an automatic failing grade. I'm afraid you're going to have to repeat the mission.
You suck.
Your score is inadequate. You'll have to repeat the mission.
Shit. Alright, we'll continue.
Cadets, this is your first Starfleet Academy mission. Several star systems are threatened by drifting minefields. Your job is to destroy the mines and to capture the devices controlling them. Further instructions will be sent to you as your mission progresses.
Bullshit.
Now, Mr. Forrester, we need you to choose your vessel. The more powerful your vessel, the more difficult the scenario will become.
Oberth.
I'd like the Oberth class vessel.
An Oberth class ship? That will be a challenge.
Are you sure you don't want a real ship?
Captain's log.
Shut up.
Stardate 2967.5. Weapons of war do not recognize truces, ceasefires, or peace treaties. They're capable of killing millennia after their wars have been forgotten. Our mission involves these weapons. We must neutralize several dangerous minefields that are threatening Federation space.
Message from Starbase, Captain.
Warp to System S-1222.
Do we have
course
to listen
laid
to
in, Captain.
No. Oh, shit, I forgot how to warp. S-Shift-W, right? All right.
Entering System 1222,
Captain. Longer than the Grissom. Exactly. Captain Esteban was a jerk.
After entering the system, go to Red Alert by pressing the A key... And then target a mine.
A-R.
Use the keypad 0, button 1 on the joystick.
Yeah. Okay, good. Let's do this. Hello? Can we get some speed gear, please? There we go. Alright, target our first standard mine. Why are we targeting this time? Last time we had that stupid circle on the side, and it wasn't targeting.
Mine destroyed.
I don't get it. I have a feeling Sulu fucked us over with our first attempt. Totally sabotaged us. What the fuck? Where is this mine? There you are, you son of a bitch. No, it's gotta be closer than that. I don't like how this stupid radar thing works either. Whatever. This one.
Mine destroyed
better than last time.
Mine destroyed.
Mind destroyed is right. Galaxy classes are for pussies, Wes. Real captains choose your berth. Need to find another mine. There we go. Found you. There you are.
Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain.
Heck yeah. Don't have Ed Sabertiff Gray at the helm. Philip asshole at tactical. It's possible. No, because Bird. Because I don't think Bird would be a woman. Hey, Kronos.
Mind destroyed. Mind destroyed.
See that bitch Sulu, right? Do any better than we are. Why won't it show me the thing on the screen? It should be like right in front of me. What the fuck? Yeah, we didn't even have to waste any torpedoes this time, tornadoes this time, either.
Mine destroyed.
I'm more than a match for these space mines.
Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed. Mine destroyed.
You shot at us. How dare you? How dare you challenge the great crew of. I don't know if our ship has a name. What should we name our ship? There we go. There you are.
Mine destroyed. Mine destroyed.
Heck yeah. Excellent shooting, whatever your name is. USS Flaming Thunderhawk. That's a good name.
After destroying all mines, target the first mine controller. Switch to disabling phases by pressing the F key. Note, photon torpedoes do not have a disabling mode.
Disabling
Using photon phases. Torpedoes on a disabled ship will destroy it. Once the mine controller is disabled, Starfleet will order you to go to system S-1622. Warp to system S-1622 by pressing Shift and W.
Mine destroyed.
Alright, we're gonna have our disabling phasers on. Just need to find this ship. Didn't it say we're supposed to disable it first and then warp away? Or should we just warp? I wasn't really paying attention. Hey, Matthew. We're just gonna spin around for a few minutes to see if we can figure out where the... Yeah, mind controller. It should be on this, like, on this map, I think. So we're gonna have to just look for it. There you are, you piece of crap. Disabling phasers are no fun. We should be able to just destroy everything in sight. We want to get a good grade.
Port side shields have been hit!
Shoot a torpedo.
Four shields have been hit! Portside shields repaired.
You have completed your mission in this system. Proceed to system 1622.
Course laid in.
That, weirdo. Hey, Tokyo. There are no evasive maneuvers.
Entering system 1622, Captain.
We get to...
Forward shields repaired. Target and destroy all mines once more. Starboard shields have been hit.
Shit. Target something. There we go.
Starboard shields repaired.
Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain.
Hell yeah, mine destroyed.
Disable second mine controller. Disable second mine controller.
Lower shields repaired.
Eat a tornado. Oh, we need some speed. Close in on that. Son of a bitch. Alright, I think we probably can't shoot in range. There we go.
Four shields have been
disabled. Second mine controller.
We only need shields.
Four shields repaired. Captain,
the mine controller is disabled.
Heck yeah.
Upper shields have been hit!
Mine destroyed. Mine destroyed. Mine destroyed.
Upper shields repaired.
Mine destroyed. Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain.
Right. What's next?
Starboard shields repaired.
There's another standard mine around here somewhere. There it is. Can't hide from the magnificent flaming Thunderhawk. Oh, let's go faster. It's taking quite a while. I'll slow down.
Mine destroyed, Captain.
Tracture the mind controller. While the controller is targeted and within 2,000 units, press the T key.
Oh shit, where's that ship? Alright, we need to find the mind controller ship that we disabled earlier. Apparently our sensors don't work because it doesn't show us anything. We'll just do our tactical spinning in circles until we see the... blue square. I could have swore it was like this way, towards the sun, maybe? There's gotta be a way to, like... There we go. This doesn't help. This screen is of no help. What does this screen do? There we go. We want the... Okay, that's the birth. I think the thing we're looking for is maybe that? I don't know. We'll head towards that. What the fuck is going on? No target. Trying to select whatever. There. See, it looks like the. Alright. Previous, next. There we go. Target acquired. Scan that son of a bitch. I don't know what the hell's going on. I don't see it on the screen, though. Maybe we're just, like, flying past it. We'll slow down. Can't fire at it. We have to tractor it. This is where we usually fail the mission. It's because I usually do blow this thing. Alright, there it is. So we have to get within a certain amount of distance. I think it's 2,000 meters or something like that. And I think they said press the T key.
Object is out of range.
Yeah, okay. And then we're going to have to bring it back to the starbase, but this time I can't ram that ship into the starbase like I did last time. Because I blew everybody up.
Object is out of range. Object is out of range. Object is out of range. Object is out of range.
It doesn't even say like the range or anything. Shit. No. There we go. Maybe that's what the numbers are on the center screen, that 12,000 or whatever.
Object is out of range.
Probably. I just don't remember what distance they said. I think it was 2,000.
Object is out of range.
We'll find out soon enough. I just don't want to run into it.
Object is out of range.
Shit. It's a tense moment, guys.
Object is out of range.
We have a chance to complete a mission for once and actually get a grade of A for awesome.
Object is out of range.
'25, '24, '23, '22, '21.
You have successfully tractored the mind controller. Starfleet will be pleased.
Warp to Starbase by pressing Shift and W.
Heck yeah. Let's go. Don't run into the Starbase. We need to get close-ish, I believe, but not run into it. What the? Thought maybe it would tell us like our mission, but it doesn't. See, this is where I got confused and I didn't know what to do. And we're gonna just release it and see what happens. Nothing.
We can't move an object that large with our tractor beams, Captain.
Oh shit. So maybe we need to be closer.
Destroyed the mind controller. Next time, use a lower power setting on your phasers.
I didn't even shoot it. Did I shoot it? I hit a button on accident. God damn it.
Forward shields online.
Well, I mean, we obviously failed our mission, so what the fuck? I don't know what it wants us to do. Can we like communicate? Five sensors. I don't know what that means. I'm about to. Tell us what we're supposed to do. Or I'm gonna open fire. Surrender now, Starbase. Life support? Oh, shit.
We have a hull breach, Captain!
Heavy casualties on all decks, Captain.
During the course of your mission, your ship was lost.
There's like
that is an automatic
no
failing grade. I'm afraid you're going to have to repeat the mission. Your score is inadequate.
Fuck you.
You'll have to repeat the mission.
You didn't even tell me what the mission was. We did complete the mission. We brought the ship back to the Starbase and let it go. And you didn't say anything. So I got confused and started pushing buttons. Idiots. Ridiculous. Now I have to do this all over again. It pisses me off. This is what I don't get. Man, create mission. We can create our own mission. Can we fight a Starfleet ship, maybe? No. What the fuck?
Cadets, this is your first Starfleet Academy mission.
Alright.
Several star systems are threatened by drifting minefields. Your job is to destroy the mines and to capture the devices controlling them. Further instructions will be sent to you as your mission progresses. Now, Mr. Forrester, we need you to choose your vessel. The more powerful your vessel, the more difficult the scenario will become.
I'd like the Oberth-class vessel.
An Oberth-class ship? We're gonna win this.
That will be a challenge.
Captain's log.
Stardate 2967.5.
We don't watch YouTube videos.
Weapons of war do not recognize truces, ceasefires, or peace treaties.
We use our superior
They're capable
intellect.
Of killing millennia after their wars have been forgotten.
And command abilities.
Our mission involves these weapons.
Pull us through.
We must neutralize several dangerous minefields that are threatening Federation space.
Message from Starbase, Captain.
Course laid in, Captain.
Go. Do not fail me this time.
Entering system 1222, Captain.
After entering the system, go to red alert by pressing the A shark button.
Yes, really. You're not down with our abilities, Wes. This time. This is our time.
Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain.
Why can't this be like a shorter mission? The instructors are sabotaging you.
Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain.
Next time when you warp back to Starbase, hail it. Ah!
Mine destroyed, Captain.
Even think of that. You shouldn't have to hail it. They should be awaiting our arrival. And
mine destroyed.
They should be hailing us. Congratulations.
Mine destroyed.
Not failing, Wes. We're being sabotaged.
Mine destroyed.
They're space mines, Kronos. They're not asteroids.
Mine destroyed.
Up by the dirty place.
Mine destroyed.
There is nothing unusual to report, Captain.
Oh, isn't there? Spy sensors will increase our range. How do I do that? I don't know how to do that. We're gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. Just spinning in circles. There it is.
Mine
Taking this thing out.
Port side shields have been hit.
What?
Port shields have been hit.
Oh, it's that stupid mind controller. I'm going to the non-lethal phasers. Slow down a little bit so we can.
Lower shields repaired. Port side shields have been hit! Shields have been, port side shields down to 50%.
After destroying all mines, target once the mine controller
mine destroyed.
You have completed your mission in this system. Proceed to system 1622.
Yes.
Course laid in, Captain.
Oh, it's faster this time.
Entering system 1622, Captain.
Target and destroy all mines once more.
Mine destroyed. Mine destroyed. Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain.
Disable second mine controller. Disable second mine controller.
Shit, what? Mind controller, there you are. Oh, you can't get away, mind controller.
Port side shields have been hit! Shields repaired.
The mind controller is disabled.
All right.
Mine destroyed, Captain.
What the fuck? There's clearly one right now.
Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain.
I can move around the station by clicking.
Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain. Mine destroyed, Captain.
Port side shields repaired.
Oh. What's this? Ship status. What are you? Science. Scan, long range scan. There we go. That's what we wanted. Shit. Not long range enough, asshole. Still have another mine out there we have to find. And then we're going to have to find the ship again. There it is. Keep going around. So we got this dude. He's the engineer, it looks like. We got this guy. That's communications. The emergency exit, bathroom, science guy. Just random shit, apparently.
Oh. Mine destroyed.
Why aren't you automatically talking about shit?
Portside shields have been hit!
Mine destroyed.
Tractor the mine controller. While the controller is targeted and within 2,000 units, press the T key.
Seem to be coming up on sensors at all. Usually when you hit the button, then fine, I'll stop, weirdos. Let's go to our science guy.
Portside shields repaired.
Mind controller. Okay. So we just want to put him in front of us, I guess. Like so.
Target the weapon system. Disable the weapons and then tractor the mind controller into your hold.
Oh, I think we're going backwards. That's the problem. Okay, so we're 51,000 whatever away from it. Maximum speed. There it is. All right, we just can't run into it this time. They killed my son. They killed all of us. They killed my entire crew twice already. We have to avenge everyone's deaths. The engineer has a way to increase power and stuff. Alright, we'll check it in after we tractor it. Otherwise, I'm going to forget about it and we'll accidentally run into the ship again. Alright, and whatever I need to make sure I don't hit the space bar either, because that's apparently the phaser button. I think that's what I did last time and accidentally destroyed the ship while we were trying to figure shit out at the starbase. Can I fight Viger? Be nice. Slow down so we don't hit this thing. We're within 5,000 meters. Getting ready to tractor. Right, speed up a little bit so this doesn't take forever.
You have successfully tractored the mine controller. Starfleet will be pleased.
Walk
to Starbase by pressing Shift and W.
It seems like that's it. Let's warp to the Starbase. We'll do that. He'll hail them this time, instead of ramming them. Hail. Oh, Starbase. Hail.
Hailing frequency open.
Everything is going fine, Forrester.
Everything is going fine. Forrester out.
Oh, okay.
Mission accomplished, Starfleet.
Congratulations.
Mission accomplished.
You have dealt with overwhelming odds in a manner consistent with the best traditions of Starfleet.
That's it? Underwhelming. We're going to save. Why won't you save? Fine.
Good afternoon, crew.
Hey, hello, dude.
I asked y'all to meet me here so we could get acquainted. Did everyone get a drink?
You all here to get you drunk?
Any chance of something stronger?
Especially you.
Not on my salary. So, you want to sit down?
I'd like to show you my tribble.
So, what did you think of Rothro's speech today?
Well, I didn't agree with Rothro. I mean, you can't invent a rule for every situation.
Perhaps not, but statistically speaking, the current Starfleet regulations have brought the Federation unprecedented success.
I don't think we have a choice here. If we don't follow the established procedures, we simply invite chaos.
Starfleet's not perfect, Janna, and neither are the regs.
Perhaps not, but I didn't apply to Starfleet because I thought I knew better than the best minds in the Federation.
Well, maybe you didn't, but I know I have something to offer
Whatever,
to Starfleet.
Spots.
Why did you get
spots
or
some weird STD on your face?
I bought my way in. Hey,
Please,
don't look so surprised.
Calm down.
There's a 2-for-1 sale on shuttlecraft today.
Look, Korn, this may be a joke to you, but it is a privilege to be here at Starfleet. I worked hard to get here.
So, Janna, how did you get here anyway? Stealing the local shuttle or just hitching a ride on your garbage car?
Fucked an admiral. Let the two of them handle it themselves. Both of you stop. Korin, you're out of line. Or Janna, back off. So essentially, what should we do? Should we let the two of them fight it out? Yell at both of them to stop? Take the man's side or take the woman's side? I think we should take Jenna's side. Just so we can maybe calm her ass down and make her let them fight. So one vote for let them fight. Anybody else have an opinion? His white privilege is showing. All right, I guess we're going to let him fight. Tear out his eyes, Janna.
Let the two of them handle it themselves.
David, it's your responsibility to restore order.
It's my responsibility to stop. Both of you stop. Or this time. Okay, so we can either make both of them stop, or we can take the black man's side, or we can take the woman's side. So I guess fighting is not an option. Fucking Starfleet. This Vulcan ruined all of our fun. We could have watched an awesome death battle in Proto 10 forward. He is a prick. Exactly. We have a choice between either racism or sexism, or we can say both. Cronus says both. All right. Cronus is the first one.
Both of you stop!
She can't take a joke.
You provoked the fight. You're right, Janna. Let it go. Or no one acts like this on my crew. So we get to, essentially yell at Korin, yell at Janna, or basically let my ego take over. 1, 2, or 3. We'll do it that way. This trill is very creepy. Establish my command dominance. You got it, John. No one acts like this on my crew, Jack.
No one acts like this on my crew.
I'm really sorry.
we're kind of contradicting ourselves since we were originally just going to let them battle to the death.
Look, now Maybe that's enough getting acquainted for today.
In the interest of completeness, I suggest we hear from Robin.
Oh, right. Robin? What about you?
I want that other woman.
I wasn't even sure I wanted to join Starfleet.
Can we exchange?
I was happy working on the weather control satellite monitoring systems. Starfleet's a lot more socially complex.
Socially complex? Karn?
Sorry.
Oh, Karin. I was calling him Karin.
I just want to be able to serve, that's all.
I concur. When one has the capabilities that are used to the minute, service is the only logical response.
I agree. Absolutely.
And we'll all get that chance. To the crew.
To the crew.
Here, here.
To my crew, I think you mean. I think my character likes the Andorian. He keeps looking over at her.
The Kelsey Collective, a culture which died over 100,000 years ago, marked their territory with highly radioactive marker buoys. As with all Kelsey artifacts, Federation law prohibits their removal from that system. And we have several probes monitoring any activity that may endanger their status. Recently, our probe in the Huron system malfunctioned. It is your mission to replace that probe. In addition to that, duty cadets, you are to protect the artifacts of the Kelsey Collective at all costs.
Captain's log, stardate 2980.6. Right. We've been assigned to the Huron system to replace a faulty probe that monitors a field of artifacts. We expect an uneventful mission.
Warp to the Huron system by pressing Shift and W.
Course laid in, Captain.
Let's do it.
Entering Huron system, Captain. The edge of the Kelsey Collective artifact field is dead ahead, Captain.
Target a buoy or probe debris by pressing either the keyboard slash and asterisk keys or the keypad zero or period keys. Non-hostile targets and non-ship targets are selected using the keyboard slash or asterisk keys. Do not target Artifact Buoy 1. Launch a replacement probe by pressing the P key. Probes are modified photon torpedoes without the warhead. So they are also taken from your photon complement. Don't use them recklessly.
Captain, sensors are detecting a freighter within the restricted zone. It is the Kaizag, a stolen freighter that was reported missing stardate 5680.2. Captain, it is removing a marker buoy. Captain, the Kaizag has gone into warp. It has set course for the Onyx system.
Course laid in, Captain.
Follow the Kaizag to the Onyx system.
You've stolen our buoy. Surrender
now
our buoy.
Now entering Onyx system, Captain.
For destruction. Red alert.
Captain, the freighter has released the artifact. It is heading directly for Onyx 2.
Capture the artifact, boy, before it hits the planet. Go to yellow alert by pressing the A and then Y keys, and target the artifact boy by pressing the keypad zero or period keys. Then get within 2,000 units and tractor beam the boy by using the T key.
Approaching object. Radiation approaching hazardous levels.
We have the buoy in our tractor beam, sir. The buoy has been released, sir.
What the fuck?
Object is out of range.
I think we're going too fast.
The buoy in our tractor beam, sir.
Now what?
Um
Markai has left the system. He has escaped.
Warp to Starbase by pressing Shift and W. Warp to Starbase by pressing Shift and W.
I didn't know we were supposed to go.
Hail Starfleet this. By pressing H, then 1 when you are in front of the base. And report your mission accomplished.
Okay. Hailing frequency open.
Mission accomplished.
Mission accomplished, Star. Mission accomplished.
We didn't do shit, but...
During the mission, many unforeseen circumstances occurred. However, you were sent to launch a probe into the Huron artifacts field. You failed to meet your objectives. Your score is inadequate. You'll have to repeat the mission.
What the fuck? You weren't clear on your orders, sir. I'm going to say that's your fault, not ours. All right, we're going to do
the Kelsey Collective, a culture which died over 100,000 years ago, marked their territory with highly radioactive marker buoys. As with all Kelsey artifacts, Federation law prohibits their removal from that system, and we have several probes monitoring any activity that may endanger their status. Recently, our probe in the Huron system malfunctioned. It is your mission to replace that probe. In addition to that, duty cadets, you are to protect the artifacts of the Kelsey Collective at all costs.
Captain's log, Stardate 2980.6.
We already did, Konos.
We've been assigned to the Huron system to replace a faulty probe that monitors a field of artifacts. We expect an uneventful mission.
I think so. That's me.
Warp to the Huron system by pressing Shift and W.
Course laid in, Captain.
I don't like you, Corin. I'm going to replace you as soon as possible.
Entering Huron system, Captain.
So, I mean,
the edge of the Kelsey Collective artifact field is dead ahead, Captain.
Target a buoy or probe debris by pressing either the keyboard slash and asterisk keys or the keypad zero or period keys. Non-hostile targets and non-ship targets are selected using the keyboard slash or asterisk
okay,
keys.
Okay, so we just need to...
Do not... Target Artifact Buoy 1. Launch a replacement probe by pressing the P key.
Okay, that's what we need.
Probes are modified photon torpedoes.
Captain, sensors are detecting a freighter within the restricted zone. It is the Kaizab, a stolen freighter that was reported missing Stardate 5680.
Probe away.
Captain, it is removing a marker buoy. Replacement probe launched. Mission objective complete. Captain, the Kaizab has gone into warp. It is set course for the Onyx system.
Course laid in, Captain.
Well, after that,
follow the Kaizag to the Onyx system.
Now entering Onyx system,
be destroyed.
We can't use our tractor beams on that, Captain.
Captain, the freighter has released the artifact. It is heading directly for Onyx 2.
Capture the artifact, boy, before it hits the planet. Go...
Deal with that freighter afterwards this time.
Approaching object. Radiation approaching hazardous levels.
Have the buoy in our tractor beam, sir.
Your shields have been, the port side shields are critical, sir. Shields repaired.
Piece of shit.
Forward shields
shields. That shield system is damaged. Repair crews are working on it.
Return the Kazakh's hail by pressing H, then 2. Request the captain to surrender. Be diplomatic, but firm. Target the Kazakh by pressing the keypad 0 and period keys. Accelerate to full speed by pressing O on the keyboard and chase it down before it escapes. Switch to disabling phases by pressing F. Criminals should not be attacked with deadly force unless they are in immediate danger to your ship or the Federation. Now attack him until he hails you.
Forward shields repaired.
Try hailing him by pressing H and then 2 when you are within 10,000 units.
I think we destroyed him.
Lower shields online.
I think we ran into him and destroyed him. Oops. Shit. Whoop the hero, stop buoy. Did we lose the buoy? Shit. Where's the planet? Something's gone wrong because it's gone really quiet. So I'm guessing we failed the mission again.
Portside shields repaired.
Phasers ready, Captain.
Lower shields repaired.
I don't know what the hell happened, but I think we lost. I think the buoy was destroyed when we accidentally collided with the ship we were fighting. So I think the game might be stuck. You know what? All right, here's what we'll do. Can we stop? We'll stop for a second. Hey, Daniels, and then let's go to Science Man. Long range scan. There's nothing out there. Launch a probe for no reason. What's that? Oh, that's our probe. All right, so I think we're fucked. Hail. All right, we're just gonna go back to the starbase and probably get some bad news.
Sir, there is no power to the warp drive.
What?
Life support system online.
Oh, we must have been severely damaged. what are you? Let's see. Warp. Systems online. Warp. Damage. Reset? What? I don't know. Damage control. That's what we want. Damage control.
We are out of transporter range, sir. Okay.
I don't know what the hell that was. We're going to go to end red alert. Then we'll try warp again. There we go. We've repaired them, Thomas. Hail the star.
Hailing frequency open.
Mission accomplished, sir.
Despite the Kazakh's actions, Starfleet does not condone its murder, cadet.
You should have worked harder to capture the Kazakh and bring its captain to justice.
Bullshit, it ran into us. How are we supposed to...
Your score is inadequate.
Fuckers.
You'll have to repeat the mission.
Now I'm pissed. That was bullshit. We should have passed that. It wasn't our fault that they literally ran into us. We're lodging a formal complaint with somebody. All right, we'll do this.
The Kelsey Collective, a culture which died over 100,000 years ago,
bullshit,
marked their territory with highly radioactive marker buoys.
Captain's log, Stardate 2980.6.
We're out of time.
We've been assigned to the Hurons.
All right. Warp to the Huron system by pressing Shift and W.
We're going to do that. All right, you know what?
Course laid in, Captain.
If we run out of time and have to restart it, we have to restart it. I'll be right back, guys. Got some consolation candy. We're ready to go. Commander candy. All right. Go to warp, whatever your name is. All right, this time we're not failing, guys. We're getting this.
Entering Huron system, Captain. The edge of the Kelsey Collective artifact field is dead ahead, Captain.
Target a buoy or probe debris by pressing either the keyboard slash launch a replacement probe by pressing...
Captain, sensors are detecting a freighter within the restricted zone. It is the Kaizag, a stolen freighter that was reported missing Stardate 5680.2. Captain, it is removing a marker buoy. Replacement probe launched. Mission objective complete. Captain, the Kaizag has gone into warp. It has set course for the Onyx system.
Down.
Now entering Onyx system, Captain.
All right, I think our mistake was firing
Captain,
at the ship.
Captain, the freighter has
time.
Released the artifact. It is heading directly for Onyx 2.
Capture the artifact, boy, before it hits the planet. Go to yellow alert by pressing the A and then Y keys, and target the artifact, boy, by pressing the keypad 0 or period keys. Then get with...
We'll play this by Starfleet rules this time. And be giant pussies. And not fire first.
Approaching object. Radiation approaching hazardous levels.
We have the buoy in our tractor beam, sir.
All Hail that son of a bitch.
They're not returning our hails, Captain.
Keep trying.
They're not returning our hails, Captain. They're not returning our hails, Captain.
Really? Disabling phasers only.
They're not returning our hails, Captain. They're not returning our hails, Captain. They're not returning our hails, Captain.
Right, we're gonna have to disable them. Can't let them get away this time.
Return the Kazakh's hail by pressing H, then 2. Request the captain to surrender. Be diplomatic, but firm.
Operator has been disabled.
I am Captain Marv Markai of the Federation Freighter Kaizak. I intend to file an official protest on your actions and this unprovoked attack.
File all the protests you want. This will be over before they even hear it. I'd say,
You have just stolen an artifact and endangered a planet, and you expect me to take your protest seriously?
That's option one. Option two is...
Freighter Kai, save it for the courts, Markai. If you don't surrender now, you won't be given a second chance.
That's option two. Option three is...
Freighter Kaizag, this is the USS Banting. We request that you stand down immediately and surrender.
And four.
Stop whining, Markai. We still have power in our phaser bank, and I'd hate to see it go to waste.
I'm thinking because of the clue we got to be firm, but whatever. But Starfleet-like, I'm guessing this
Freighter
is the one
Kaizag,
that we're supposed to pick.
This is the USS Banting. We request that you stand down immediately and surrender.
Or...
You have just stolen an artifact and endangered a planet, and you expect me to take your protest seriously?
I think option three is what we're supposed to do. What do you guys think? Option one, two, three, or four? My vote's three, but I'll go with whatever decision you guys want to do. I mean, to be honest, my vote is to fire photon torpedoes at this idiot, but...
Stop whining, Markai. We still have power in our phaser bank, and I'd hate to see it go to waste.
This is the one Kronos wants. Do it, Dark Side. All right, here we go.
Don't threaten me, human. It's far better to die than to allow such an insult to go unchallenged.
All right.
Your posturing doesn't impress me one little bit, Markai.
That's one.
Your ship is barely intact, Markai. It won't survive another hit. Why don't you just surrender?
That's two.
If that's what you want. Of course, I'd be willing to accept the surrender.
Three.
Surrender or die, Markai.
And four. That one kind of sounds like me. All right. So I think the most Starfleet one on this one is going to be... I don't know. Probably three. Again, would probably be the most Starfleet. surrender or die. I think our goal, guys, I think our goal here is to get him to surrender. If you really want me to threaten him, I will. But we might have to do the mission over again. Send him to hell. All right. Surrender or die, apparently. Man, I hope you don't have to do this over again.
Surrender or die. Are you so certain of victory then, human?
They're not returning our hail.
Let's keep hitting with the disabling phase. See if we can get maybe. Otherwise, we'll probably just have to end with the Photon Torpedo. I think he's dead in the water. In space. Yeah, I think we probably should have, because now I think we have no choice but to destroy their ship. Actually, you know what? Let's go our tactical guy. We're gonna target their scan target. We're gonna target their warp drive. See what happens.
The buoy has been released, sir.
Ah, shit. We released the buoy.
We have the buoy in our tractor beam, sir.
Bye-bye, Kazog. Beautiful phasers. Alright, you know what? We're just gonna leave and see what happens. We left him alive. That shouldn't be an automatic kill.
Approaching object. Radiation approaching hazardous levels.
Hailing frequency open.
Mission accomplished.
Congratulations.
Sweet.
You have dealt with overwhelming odds in a manner consistent with the best traditions of Starfleet.
So we passed, guys. Awesome. All we had to do was not destroy that guy. I mean, I guess being a dick didn't matter. So I guess noted for future reference.
Once you're out of direct communication with Starfleet, you'll face challenges we cannot anticipate.
Fucking Sulu.
Your ship, and maybe even the entire Federation, will have to live with the consequences of your decisions. Now, despite the events presented in the first two simulations, we are not just testing your combat ability. You must be able to make well-informed decisions.
Unlike you.
Good afternoon, class. We have a guest speaker today. An expert on Klingon affairs. Captain James T. Kirk.
Thank you, Commandant Rutherford. I'd like to say that I'm honored to teach these fine young cadets. There is a serious situation on the Klingon border. A small Klingon and Romulan combined fleet has crossed the neutral zone and is advancing on Epsilon 4. Now, there's some bad blood between the Epsilon colonists and the Klingons for decades. We believe the Klingons are planning some sort of punitive action against the colony. That still doesn't explain why they're working with Romulans.
They're dirty traitors. It will be up to you to
protect the Epsilon system until reinforcements arrive without starting a war. Do not return to base until you get authorization from Starfleet. Dismissed.
Captain's log, stardate 4055.4. A long, bloody war with the Klingons is probably the Federation's greatest fear. And once again, an incursion from the Klingons has brought us to the brink.
Course laid in, Captain.
Wait, what is this bullshit? Why are we in a different ship? They took our old berth away from us, guys. They made us go in a fucking Constitution class. I protest. Bullshit.
Captain, I'm receiving a distress signal from the Medusan freighter Auriga in Beta Epsilon. It's being attacked by a Klingon bird of prey.
Course laid in, Captain.
I don't know what we're supposed to do.
A Klingon bird of prey is attacking the freighter, entering Beta Epsilon system.
And maybe inside of our old birth class, we might have a chance to save
us. The bird of prey is moving to intercept us. Photon tubes have been hit!
Phasers are unavailable.
Photon tubes have been hit!
Phasers are unavailable.
Photon tubes at 50% efficiency. Forward shields have been hit.
Something is warping into the system.
Upper shields have been hit. Those upper shields are critical, sir. The shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working on it.
Save this guy.
Aft shields repaired.
Phasers are online again, ready to fire on your orders.
They've been online, dude. We're seriously
phasers
just
are operational out. Again, Captain.
Apparently, it doesn't matter if our weapons are offline because we can still shoot.
Upper shields have been hit! Lower shields have been hit! Port side shields online. Upper shields repaired. Lower shields repaired. Lower shields down to 50%. Lower shields are critical, sir! Lower shields are critical. The shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working on it.
Because we just rammed the shit out of that ship. Alright, boom goes the shitty bird of prey. That wasn't even a challenge. Now what? Science guy, I need you to scan the area.
Forward shields online.
This is a standard intersystem freighter. It has minimal armament and an engine capability of no better than Warp 3.
Captain, I'm receiving a distress signal from the freighter Drake and Gamma Epsilon. It's being attacked by a Klingon bird of prey.
Captain, the warp drive is not online.
Oh, shit. I think we're heavily damaged again. We'll just go to yellow alert. Maybe we can bleed some power to our warp drive.
Lower shields repaired.
Entering Gamma Epsilon system.
A Klingon bird of prey is attacking the freighter. Captain, the bird of prey is moving to intercept us.
Where?
Klingon bird of prey decloaking.
Crystals are... Starboard shields have been hit! Lower shields have been hit! Lower shields are incredible, sir! Starboard shields prepared.
Our targeting scanners seem to be shit.
Half shields have been hit. Four shields down to 50%. Aft shields repaired. Port side shields are hit. Four shields down to 50%. Lower shields are critical, sir. Upper shields are critical, sir.
All right, I think we need to stop ramming shit. That's our problem.
Forward shields online. Lower shields repaired. Starboard shields repaired.
Welcome back.
Lower shields down to 50. Forward shields are critical, sir. Lasers are operational again, Captain.
You do a lot of sucks. I think that's what's broken.
Shields repaired. Upper shields repaired.
Yeah.
Port side shields repaired.
Eat a dick. Get us to the Drake. Hail them.
Captain, the freighter reports that all is well.
Good for them. I have no idea.
Phasers are online again, ready to fire on your orders.
They've been online. Shut up. Now what are we doing? I know we can't go back to Starbase until we're told to, so I'm guessing just hang out here until another ship starts attacking somewhere. Not run into that one.
We can't move an object that large with our tractor beams, Captain.
It's a ship. Why can't we tractor it?
Hailing frequency open.
Starfleet, we've lost our warp nacelles. Requesting immediate assistance.
What?
Starfleet, everything is going...
Everything's going fine. We have not lost our warp nacelles. Have we? Engineer. Yeah, we're okay. Warp system's good. We just got some hull damage. I think we're okay. We're gonna warp, see what happens. Not sure where we're going. Do we go to another system?
Entering the Epsilon system.
Epsilon system.
The Klingon is moving to intercept us.
Captain, Epsilon 4 reports they've been attacked by Klingons. Governor Ryan has been taken prisoner and is being transported back to the command ship.
Forward shields have been hit. Forward shields are critical, sir. That shield system is damaged. Lower shields down to 50%.
The D7 shields are down. We are now using the line.
It's trying to cause us to ramp.
Forward shields online. Half shields have been hit. Port side shields have been hit. Aft shields repaired. Forward shields down to 50%. Port side shields repaired.
My vessel is destroyed. And Governor Ryan is dead.
Incoming message from Starfleet, Captain. Priority 2.
Open a channel.
USS Agincourt, this is Starfleet. A Romulan ship has just attacked the Federation research base on Pascal 2. The attack on Epsilon was just a diversion. Return to base immediately. Starfleet out.
Captain, I'm getting a transmission beamed on all channels from Klingon space.
On screen, Lieutenant.
I am Kumas, governor of the Hansnar province, patriarch of Clan Tarkat, and hero of Kronos 4. For years, we have been forced to endure the treachery of the Federation colonists of Epsilon 4. Now they are arming rebels on the Klingon world of Inta. This will not be tolerated. I promise the Klingon people, we will have justice, or we will have blood.
Course laid in, Captain.
Starfleet has just sent their condolences to the family of the late Governor Ryan. Fortunately, this was just a simulation, and you have a chance to get back to the simulator and do it right this time. There are a lot of Starfleet captains who'd like that chance in the real world.
What?
Your score isn't what we hoped to see from you, Cadet. Take the mission again, and this time, think about your decisions.
What the hell? They're not very clear with what they want us to do. Or was I missing something? Because I feel like we did everything perfectly. We destroyed all the dirty Klingon ships. Who beam who up? The guy on the Klingon ship that I was destroying, or what? I didn't know who I was supposed to beam up. All right, we'll try again.
Good afternoon, class. We have a guest speaker today, an expert on Klingon affairs, Captain James T. Kirk.
Okay.
Thank you, Commandant Rutherford.
On the Klingon ship.
I'd like to say that I'm honored to teach these fine young cadets. There is a serious situation on the Klingon border. A small Klingon and Romulan combined fleet has crossed the neutral zone and is advancing on Epsilon 4. Now, there's some bad blood between the Epsilon colonists and the Klingons for decades. We believe the Klingons are planning some sort of punitive action against the colony. That still doesn't explain why they're working with Romulans. It will be up to you to protect the Epsilon system until reinforcements arrive without starting a war. Do not return to base until you get authorization from Starfleet. Dismissed.
Captain's log, stardate 4055.4.
I was in the
A long, bloody war with the Klingons is probably the Federation's greatest fear.
I wish we could go
and once again, an incursion from the Klingons has brought us to the brink.
Course laid in, Captain.
Captain, I'm receiving a distress signal from the Medusan freighter Auriga in Beta Epsilon. It's being attacked by a Klingon bird of prey.
Course laid in, Captain.
Let's do this, crew.
A Klingon bird of prey is attacking the freighter.
Entering Beta Epsilon system.
Not on my watch.
Captain,
not.
The bird of prey is moving to intercept us.
Your shields have been hit! Your shields are critical, sir!
Something is working on the system.
Lower shields have been hit! Lower shields are critical, sir! Upper shields down to 50%. Phasers have been hit! Aft shields repaired. Forward shields online. Our aft shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working on it. Aft shields down to 50%.
Ramming takes these ships out really fast.
Lower shields online. We've completed repairs on the phasers, Captain. Upper shields repaired. Lord, that shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working on it.
Son of a bitch keeps cloaking.
Forward shields, warp engines have been hit! Lower shields online. Upper shields down to 50%. Lower shields are critical, sir! That shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working on it. Phasers are operational again, Captain. Ah. Lower shields online.
Signal from the freighter Drake and Gamma Epsilon. It's being attacked by a Klingon bird of prey.
Forward shields. That shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working on it.
Entering Gamma Epsilon system. A Klingon bird of prey is attacking the freighter.
Surrender, Klingon.
Captain, the bird of prey is moving to intercept us.
Lower shields online.
Klingon bird of prey decloaking.
Port side shields down to 50. Lower shields are critical, sir. That shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working. Lower shields down to 50%. Phasers are operational again, Captain. Portside shields online. Upper shields down to 50%. Upper shields are at critical, sir. That shield system is damaged, Captain.
Why the fuck do they just keep running into me? Idiots. Kamikaze for you.
Phasers are operational again, Captain.
This is what happened.
Forward
last
shields
time.
Online. Lower shields online.
Didn't, like, say anything, so I think we just head back to the other one. All right, we're gonna hail this guy again.
Captain, the freighter reports that all is well.
Okay, good. We're gonna let some shit repair for a minute, and then we'll head back and fight the next ship.
Portside shields repaired.
Shields are repaired. Yeah, we have some serious damage. Because they keep
upper shields repaired. Forward shields repaired. Lower shields repaired.
Alright, shields are getting good. Photons are okay. I guess our life support's no good. I don't even know how to read this screen.
Crystals are realigned, Captain. Warp drives are ready.
Alright. Alright. Oh, what controls the BMD? Alright, so we can't just do it from here. Oh, damage control. Hull 9. Increase, decrease. I don't know how to increase or decrease, so that's weird. D. That's our damage control. 9 hull increase. See, I don't know what the hell those buttons are. Oh, maybe it's that. So D, 9. Oh, either. Oh. All right, we're gonna head back to the next system.
Entering the Epsilon system.
The Klingon is moving to intercept us.
Captain, Epsilon 4 reports they've been attacked by Klingons. Governor Ryan has been taken prisoner and is being transported back to the command ship.
Upper shields repaired.
The D7 shields are down, and we are now able to transport Governor Ryan aboard. We are out of transporter range, sir.
Fuck.
Port side shields have been hit! Forward shield,
they're raising their shields.
System, photon shields are 50% efficiency. We got pulse engines are critical, Captain.
We cannot
security is a critical, sir! Upper shields have been hit!
We cannot transport anyone while their shields are up, sir. We cannot transport anyone while their shields are up, sir.
Ah, shit!
Aft shields have been hit! Lower shields have been hit! Forward shields are critical, sir! Lower shields have been hit!
Oh,
shields are critical, sir!
All engines, shields are down, and we are now able to transport Governor Ryan.
Damage to the photons are critical!
For a captain to lose his ship is a major blow, I know. During this mission, your ship was lost. That is an automatic failing grade. We'll put you back in the simulator and let you try it again. So perhaps in the real universe, it won't happen to you.
Oh, I need to know what the hotkeys
are for this.
Your
score isn't what we hope to see from you, Cadet. Take the mission again, and this time,
the controller to
think
try and
about
control
your decisions.
The ship to go to the keyboard, to jump down to the keyboard, and then cycle through the stations. It just takes too long. I don't know if a tractor beam will help. Maybe we'll try that. We can try that. Okay. One day, one night. Kobayashi Maru. That's right. This bullshit. Alright. Should we try one more time for tonight? It's kind of getting late. I wasn't going to stream that long tonight, but kind of irritated with this. Alright, we're going to try one more time.
Good afternoon, class. We have a guest speaker today. An expert on Klingon affairs. Captain James T. Kirk.
Smoke a cigarette.
Thank you, Commandant Rutherford.
like to say that I'm honored to teach these fine young cadets. There is a serious situation on the Klingon border. A small Klingon and Romulan combined fleet has crossed the neutral zone and is advancing on Epsilon 4. Now, there's some bad blood between the Epsilon colonists and the Klingons.
You know what we should do before we start the mission, maybe.
We believe the Klingons are planning some sort of punitive action.
Captain's log, stardate 4.
Course laid in, Captain.
Settings, keyboard. Okay, so hull H, hail is H, hull, moron. Cycle camera view is F2. I don't think that helps. View right. Okay, F9. It's like different views. I don't know what that would help. Change radar, display tab, warp W. Disabling weapons or F, cloak, decloak C, emergency power G. Transporter is I. Is that an I? That looks like an I. We're gonna hit I and see what happens.
Captain, there is nothing there we can transport.
Okay, so I is transporters. All right, I think we can do it this time, guys.
Captain, I'm receiving a distress signal from the Medusan freighter Auriga in Beta Epsilon. It's being attacked by a Klingon bird of prey.
Course laid in, Captain.
A Klingon bird of prey is attacking the freighter.
Entering Beta Epsilon system.
Captain, the bird of prey is moving to intercept us.
Always.
Captain, something is warping into the system.
Lower shields have been hit!
Nice we could find our fucking target.
Lower shields repaired. Upper shields repaired. Aft shields repaired.
What's up?
Upper shields down to 50%. Lower shields down to 50%. Portside shields repaired. Lower shields down to 50%.
Damn it, it keeps cloaking.
Upper shields repaired.
Later, Josh.
Lower shields down to 50%. Upper shields have been hit.
Target that fucking ship. Oh my god.
Upper shields repaired. Shields are a critical, sir! Tractor beams have been hit!
This time it's cloaking a lot more than it did last time. It's kind of annoying.
Upper shields have been hit! Lower shields are a critical, sir!
Captain, I'm receiving a distress signal from the freighter Drake and Gamma Epsilon. It's being attacked by a Klingon bird of prey.
We've completed repairs on the tractor beam, sir. Forward shields repaired. Forward shields down 50%.
Okay.
repair crews are working on it. Upper shields repaired.
All right.
We've completed repairs on the track.
Entering Gamma Epsilon system.
A Klingon bird of prey is attacking the freighter. Captain, the bird of prey is moving to intercept us. Klingon bird of prey decloaking.
Lower shields down to 50%. Starboard shields have been hit. Shields repaired. Upper shields have been hit.
Phasers are online again, ready to fire on your orders.
Starboard shields repaired.
Phasers are online again, ready to fire on your orders.
This view.
Upper shields repaired. Starboard shields have been hit. Lower shields are critical, sir. Aft shields have been hit. Upper shields down to 50%.
I'm gonna be honest, this one's actually a little harder to use.
Aft shields repaired. Lower shields are critical, sir! Lower shields are critical, sir! That shield system is damaged, Captain. Warp engines are critical! Captain, the warp drive can't take it. I need more time to repair them. Forward shields repaired. Upper shields repaired. Aft shields have been hit! Upper shields have been hit! Lower shields down to 50%! Front side shields repaired. Upper shields repaired. Lower shields online. Lower shields down to 50%! Shields repaired.
Captain, the freighter reports that all is well.
We've completed repairs on the tractor beam, sir.
Damage control warp. Alright, we're starting warping right now. Alright, we're good.
Captain, the warp drive is not online.
Shit. No, we're not good. Last time we let us do it when we were in yellow alert, so we'll try again.
Captain, the warp drive is not online.
Emergency power. I mean, it says system online. Give our warp engine 100%. Try that.
Sir, there is no power to the warp drive.
Just gave it power. The fuck? I need you to fix this warp drive. Okay, they're yellow now. We should be good. Okay, efficiency. 72, 74. All right, that's good. So I'm guessing it's fixed. I don't know how this. I just don't know how the screen works. All right, so we're gonna balance this out to be normal, I guess. Impulse is yellow still. Warp drive looks okay.
The warp drives are fit as a fiddle now, Captain.
Alright, so now we just need to... Alright, we're good. We're good. Go back to red alert. I had to warp.
Entering the Epsilon system.
The Klingon is moving to intercept us.
Captain, Epsilon 4 reports they've been attacked by Klingons. Governor Ryan has been taken prisoner and is being transported back to the command ship.
The shields have been hit!
57
shields are down, and we are now able to transport Governor Ryan aboard. We have him.
Sir, a warning order is decoded. The D7 has triggered an auto-destruct sequence, Captain.
Incoming message from Starfleet, Captain. Priority 2.
USS Agincourt, this is Starfleet. A Romulan ship has just attacked the Federation research base on Pasco 2. The attack on Epsilon was just a diversion. Return to base immediately.
Captain, I'm getting a transmission beamed on all channels from Klingon space.
On screen, Lieutenant.
I am Kumas, governor of the Hand
Transporter.
Province.
We got him, though. So
patriarch
okay.
Of Clan Tarkat and hero of Kronos 4. For years, we have been forced to endure the treachery of the Federation colonists of Epsilon 4.
I swear, God, if we
now they are arming rebels on the Klingon world of Inta. This will not be tolerated. I promise the Klingon people, we will have justice, or we will have blood.
Course laid in, Captain.
Get us out of here.
Captain, the warp drive is not online.
Oh, shit. I should defeat this dirty Romulan. Hail that dirty Romulan. Star.
They're not talking, Captain.
Upper shields repaired.
Foolish Romulan.
Lower shields repaired. Forward shields repaired.
Hail the fucking Starbase.
Hailing frequency open.
Mission accomplished, Starfleet. Mission accomplished.
You've done well, Cadet.
Thank you, Captain.
The governor was saved. And so are the freighters. Your crew works well together.
And we also
destroyed
Romulan.
In spite of their occasional bickering.
Hey, Professor.
You did extraordinarily well. It was a nearly flawless mission. I have nothing but praise. But I've never been particularly good with praise.
Wow. Is it a crew bond? I bet we're going to have like a crew bonding session now. Yep.
Come in. Hi, Jenna.
Oh, yeah. Me and Spots. What's up?
It's about Corrin. He's out of control.
Oh, shit. She's still angry. I've been worried about him, too. Thanks for telling me. I'll look into it. Or jokingly, trying to calm her down. If I didn't know you better, I'd say you I didn't like Corrin. We've got another decision to make, guys. Let's see. Do we pretend we're worried about Corrin, the guy we don't like? do we say we'll look into it? Or do we joke with her trying to get into her pants? Choice one, two, or three. It's up to you guys. First one that picks, that's what we'll do. $69. Get in her pants. All right.
If I didn't know better, I'd say you didn't like Corrin.
This has nothing to do with my personal opinion of Corrin. But I think he's hurting the team's morale.
All right. You're right, we should get rid of him. That's my choice. Well, look, I understand your concerns, but we're all still new at this. For now, Corrin stays. I think you'd be better off with the Andorian. Maybe. We have to decide if we were going to kick Corrin off the team or say he stays. Maybe we'll, if we kick him off, we might get the girl that was sitting behind us in the bar. And then we can dump this woman for her. Or the frigid Romulan or Andorian. Don't like the hair pulled back look. Her hair is too tight. That's why she's always angry. She has a headache all the time. Choice one or two. Hey, Pop Culture. We're playing Starfleet Academy. Tight hair is a trouble. No one wants to make a choice. All right. We'll go with your right. We should get rid of him. All right. We're going to be Starfleet-like.
Look, I understand your concerns, but we're all still new at this. For now, Corrin stays.
Look, it's not that I mind Corrin going out with that cadet. It's just that he wasn't even interested in her until he found out Robin had a crush on her.
Ooh.
Hold on, what cadet?
I'm talking about
Faith. She's jealous.
Gage. Haven't you heard about her?
You've got me, baby.
No, I've been too busy with my studies. Look, I'll check into it, okay?
I'll be in the simulator.
Oh yeah, she'll be in the simulator. That's euphemism.
Cadet's log, supplemental.
Sex chamber.
Apparently, I'm expected to monitor the love life of my crew, as well as lead them.
Welcome back again, cadets. Our intelligence believes that Governor Kumos, the Klingon commander behind the attack on...
I want my ship back.
...is acting without the sanction of the Klingon High Council. On top of that, there's been a battle between one of the Romulan warbirds that raided Pascal 2 and two of our ships, the USS Demeter and the USS Alexandria. Unfortunately, the Demeter was destroyed in the battle. The Romulans' warp engines were damaged as well. You will join the Alexandria and the USS Rutherford in their search for the damaged Romulan. If we're lucky, we'll catch her before she can repair her engines and warp out of the system. Good luck.
Captain's log, Stardate 3551.3. We are on a mission to intercept an intruder into Federation space, and we hope learn more about the reasons for the Klingon-Romulan invasion.
Course laid in, Captain.
I'm kind of annoyed that they took away our old birth class, making us be a Constitution.
Entering the Pascal system.
Stand for dirty Romulans.
Captain, the commanding officers of the Alexandria and the Rutherford are standing by.
Captain, I have a theory on how we might find the Romulan.
Go on.
Oh, shit.
Space is not completely empty. There are still atoms in space distributed evenly by the Big Bang. However, a cloak ship would mask these atoms and register as a perfect vacuum. A single ship would take weeks to scan even a small area of space, and they would detect more anomalies than genuine readings. However, two ships with all power diverted to sensors could serve to eliminate anomalies while a third ship searched. We might find the Romulan in hours, maybe minutes.
Lieutenant McGee, pass on Mr. Stirk's plan to the Alexandria and the Rutherford. We'll conduct the search. They'll remain on station.
Yes, sir.
So are we supposed to...
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
What is it, Mr. Stirk?
It could be an anomaly, or it could be the Romulan. We should try to localize our search.
Course laid in, Captain.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain. Captain, sensors cannot adequately scan the object at this range. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead.
Okay, I heard you the first six times. We're moving ahead. I don't know what the hell else you want me to do. We're at full speed.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Oh my God. Please shut your mouth.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
You need to shut up. Can we eject this asshole into space? Beam the Vulcan directly ahead. I have an idea.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Power sensors to maximum.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Do you guys think we're supposed to go to warp? All right, we're gonna go to warp. There. All right, we got it.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to starboard, Captain.
Alert. Going disabling phasers.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to starboard, Captain.
Oh, it's one of ours. Shit, we just destroyed
it. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Shit. I think we ran into that thing.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared astern, Captain.
Astern. All right, behind us.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared above, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to port, Captain.
don't know what I'm supposed to do. We'll scan it.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to port, Captain. These are the remains of the USS Demeter. It was destroyed by a barrage of Romulan plasma torpedoes. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to port, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared astern, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to starboard, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Okay. Should we warp again? Okay, we can't warp.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Yeah, I heard you, douchebag.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Exactly. The Romulans did it. It definitely was not us running into the ship that caused this destruction.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to port, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
I'm gonna stop. We need to figure out what the hell we're supposed to do here.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Okay. Launch a probe. We'll launch a probe.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead,
that cannot
Captain.
Cannot help us at all.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Locate the cloaked Romulan renegades. Well, how?
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Got our sensors to maximum. Feel like can't really
Captain, we found the Romulan.
There it is.
The Romulan is decloaking, sir.
Oh, shit.
The Romulan has gone into warp, Captain. Captain, two Klingon D7s have just warped into the system.
Captain, we're being hailed by the Klingons. Audio channels only.
Klingon vessel, you are in violation of the Reganian peace treaty. Surrender at once.
We Klingons do not know the meaning of that word.
Shields have been hit. The shield system is damaged, Captain. What's working on? Forward shields repaired. We've completed repairs on the tractor beam, sir. Lower shields online. Lower shields are critical, sir. That shield system is damaged, Captain. Repair crews are working on it. Forward shields have been hit. Forward shields are critical, sir. The crews are working expeditiously. Forward shields online. Forward shields online. Forward shield's critical, sir! Life support is critical! Shield's repaired.
Heavy casualties on all decks.
Part of the game.
For a captain to lose his ship is a major blow, I know. During this mission, your ship was lost.
Well, yeah,
that is an automatic failing grade. We'll put you back in the simulator and let you try it again. So perhaps in the real universe, it won't happen to you.
I don't want to try again. It's bullshit. All right.
Welcome back again, cadets.
Fuck.
Our intelligence believes that Governor Kumas, the Klingon commander behind the attack on Paskal II, is acting without the sanction of the Klingon High Council. On top of that, there's been a battle between one of the Romulan warbirds that raided Paskal II and two of our ships,
the
USS
Demeter
and the USS Alexander. Unfortunately, the Demeter was destroyed in the battle. The Romulans' warp engines were damaged as well. You will join the Alexandria and the USS Rutherford in their search for the damaged Romulan.
Okay.
If we're lucky, we'll catch her before she can repair her engines and warp out of the system. Good luck.
Captain's log, stardate 3551.3. We are on a mission to intercept an intruder into Federation space, and we hope learn more about the reasons for the Klingon-Romulan invasion.
Course laid in, Captain. Entering the Paskal system.
This game pisses me off.
Captain, the commanding officers of the Alexandria and the Rutherford are standing by.
Captain, I have a theory on how we might find the Romulan.
Go on.
Your chair is
space
so squeaky.
Space is not completely empty. There are still atoms in space distributed evenly by the Big Bang. However, a cloak ship would mask these atoms and register as a perfect vacuum. A single ship would take weeks to scan even a small area of space, and they would detect more anomalies than genuine readings. However, two ships with all power diverted to sensors could serve to eliminate anomalies while a third ship searched. We might find the Romulan in hours, maybe minutes.
Lieutenant McGee, pass on Mr. Stirk's plan to the Alexandria and the Rutherford. We'll conduct the search. They'll remain on station.
It's a good idea, sir. Actually, John. That's probably what we're going to do.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
What is it, Mr. Stirk?
It could be an anomaly, or it could be the Romulan. We should try to localize our search.
Course laid in, Captain.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
I'm not going to run into him this time. I'm just going
to scan. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to starboard, Captain.
Shut your mouth.
These are the remains of the USS Demeter. It was destroyed by a barrage of Romulan plasma torpedoes. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to starboard, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared to port, Captain. A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
Photon torpedoes are not available, Captain.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
That's where we're going, dude.
A sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead, Captain.
So last time, we had our
a sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead,
up,
Captain.
And then when I put him back down, that's when I reset everything. That's when we got the signal. So I'm going to try
a sensor anomaly briefly appeared ahead,
okay,
Captain.
I hear you. God, that guy's a douche.
Captain, we found the Romulan.
The Romulan is decloaking, sir.
The Romulan has gone into warp, Captain.
They're not talking, Captain.
Captain, two Klingon D7 have just warped into the system.
Captain, we're being hailed by the Klingons. Audio channels only.
Klingon vessel, you are in violation of the Organian Peace Treaty. Surrender at once.
We Klingons do not know the meaning of that word.
Core shields have been hit.
Boom, piece of shit.
Lower shields repaired. Lower shields down to 50%.
I'm receiving a message from Starfleet.
Yeah. We're
to return to Starbase immediately.
Course laid in, Captain.
Mission accomplished, Starfleet.
Lower shields online.
9 torpedoes left. You don't have an infinite torpedo.
Captain, I'm getting a transmission beamed on all channels from Klingon space.
I am Kumas of the Hansnar province. We have ended the insurrection in Intakh. Uncovered a Federation sensor system used to spy on our worlds and humiliated the Federation's fleet at Pascal 5.
We just destroyed two
battleships. I will not compromise the security of Hansnar province.
Go fuck yourself.
I will not bow to Federation pressure. No one will deter us from our right to act as we please to pursue the greater glory of the Klingon Empire!
Hailing frequency open.
Mission accomplished, Starfleet.
Mission accomplished.
You have done exceptionally well on this mission.
Thank you,
Dealing
Captain.
With a cloaked Romulan ship is one of the most difficult tasks you'll ever have to face.
That was easy.
Cadet's log. I was looking for Captain Sulu to hand in my weekly reports and possibly get some advice on the Korn and Robin situation.
Look at his rank. He still has a commander rank. And I said that he's not even a captain.
He was commanding the Enterprise at the time.
Sir! My report, sir.
At ease, cadets.
See?
Commander Chekov, meet David Forrester. He just might be what you're looking for.
Ah! Nice to meet you, cadet.
And you, sir. I didn't know you were teaching at the academy.
He's not really an instructor.
I'm here to develop some new simulator missions. I've had a few unorthodox ideas. By the way, Cadet Forrester, do you know your way around the simulated neurofeedback bipolar resolution assimilator?
The fuck was that?
Well, I was in the top 10% of my computer class, sir.
Tell me, Cadet, do you know what a Cossack is?
Are you Russian piece of shit?
I think they were horsemen. On the Eurasian continent of Earth in the 18th to 19th centuries, sir.
That's good.
What a brown-nosed piece of shit.
Excellent. You might be exactly what I need.
Commander Chekov needs some help with his simulation testing.
It should be a simple task for such a well-informed student as yourself. Report tomorrow to the science lab.
Commander Chekov, sir. I think I found the problem right here.
Oh, yes. Well, it's not really the problem. It looks
Cadet's log, supplemental. Well, I solved a tricky recursion problem in the Romulan cloaking simulation, and my fate was sealed. Commander Chekov asked me to assist him on a regular basis. I do have to admit, though, it's pretty amazing to see the simulations from the inside, as well as from the command chair.
All right, guys. We need to figure out how to save a game here. I don't know why it doesn't let me save, like, ever. Because it just always goes to mission one done. And I kind of want to end for the night. Oh, there we go. How did I do that? We're going to rename this one. Stream game. And save. Right, save game, yes. Alright, sweet. Alright, so we saved the game, so we'll pick this up next time. We'll probably pick this up tomorrow sometime, because I'm going to go ahead and call it a night here. But, yeah. Can't believe we're actually getting through some missions. I thought we'd be stuck on mission one for several hours, but we're doing pretty good. And it seems like Chekhov is taking a liking to us. And we still don't care about that piece of shit, Sulu. All right, guys. Thanks a lot for hanging out. I'm going to go ahead and call it a night and go to bed. Still not feeling the greatest. So I'm thinking tomorrow afternoon I might do something. I don't know. Never mind. I was going to maybe do a stream tomorrow afternoon, but we'll see. But we'll definitely jump back into this game later on in the daytime. I just don't know exactly when. But yeah. All right. Have a good night, guys. See you later. And yeah, take care. Oh, that's right. I can't tab out of this. There we go. All right, guys. Have a good night. See you later.